I welcome you to this quantum mechanics course. In today's lecture, we will be discussing about vector spaces or linear spaces. So what we are going to discuss in today's video is what are vector spaces, how they are defined, what are the properties that these vector spaces need to satisfy, and we will be understanding the vector spaces based on some example. And at the end, I am going to provide you problems so that you will understand how to say whether something forms a vector space or not. So let's begin. In vector spaces, there are two sets. One is a set of vectors. So let's say vector A, vector B, vector C, and vector D. Kindly note how I have represented vector. I am going to use this representation so that I can distinguish it from scalars. So this is a set of vectors. So what is these vectors? They can be a function, they can be a number. So we know that I have set of vectors. Vector A, vector B, vector C, vector D, so on and so forth. This is a set of vectors, and we have a set of scalars. Scalar A, B, C, D, so on and so forth. Whether it is a limited number of set or it is infinite number of set, it can be limited or infinite. Generally, in quantum mechanics, we deal with infinite number of vector spaces, vectors. Okay. So these are the scalars. What are the scalars? They are numbers. They can be real number, complex number, imaginary number, rational number. In general, when we talk about quantum mechanics, we say that these scalars are complex numbers. So the vector space is defined over a set of scalars and set of vectors. Can I take any such set of vectors and any such set of scalars and I say that, okay, these are my vector space? No, the answer is no. They need to satisfy some properties. Okay, what are those properties? Basically, in order for a set of vectors and set of scalars to form a vector space, they need to satisfy A, vector addition, and B, scalar multiplication properties. We will be discussing about these properties in detail, but let me just give you an example of what is set of vectors and set of scalars. So in your Euclidean space, the set of vectors are directional parts and a set of scalars are real numbers. So basically, whatever vector you are going to consider, let's say 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 5k cap, so this is a vector. Similarly, any number, so when you say that ai cap plus bj cap plus ck cap, you can take A, B, C to be any number. Okay, so set of all such vectors is my set of vectors. And what is scalars? Now, this particular Euclidean space is defined over real number. So any real number, you can take 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so on and so forth, or even negative numbers. Okay, so that forms your Euclidean vector space. In order to understand vector spaces, it will help you if you can correlate it. Whatever properties we are going to discuss, if you can correlate it with your Euclidean space, that time it will help you understand. Okay, so let's look into the vector addition property. Let's say I have a set of vectors, vector A, vector B, vector C, vector D, and so on and so forth. Okay, now if I add two vectors together, then it should give me another vector. And that vector should belong to the same set of vectors. So whatever set I have considered, A, B, C, if I add A plus B, then whatever resultant vector will be, that vector should belong to the same set. Something like this, A plus B is equal to C. And all these vectors, A, B, and C, should be from the set of vectors that I have considered. If it is not from the same set, then it cannot form a vector space. Now this addition property has some implications to it. The first implication is that there should be a existence of zero or null vector. What is zero or null vector? Zero or null vector is a vector which when added to some another vector gives the same vector back. So A plus null vector will give me A. If a null vector doesn't exist, then the set of vector cannot form a vector space. Then the second property of vector addition is that existence of inverse. What is an inverse vector? So when you add a vector and a inverse vector, then you will get a null vector. So vector A plus inverse of vector A will give me null vector. If an inverse vector doesn't exist, then that vector set of vectors could not form vector space. Then the third, the next property of vector addition is commutative. So basically, it doesn't matter whether I am adding A into B or B into A, the end result will be same. Okay, so the order in which you are doing the addition, it doesn't matter. That is commutative property. And then vector addition is associative. What I mean by associative is that if I am adding more than two vectors, when I was adding two vectors, the order doesn't matter. Even when I add more than two vectors, the order doesn't matter. For example, let's say that I want to add three vectors, vector A, vector B and vector C. It doesn't matter whether I am adding vector A and B first and then whatever the end product I am adding to the vector C. The end result will be same even if I add vector B into vector C first and then add vector A into the whatever the result. Okay, the end result will be same. So here also the order of vector addition doesn't matter. For a set of vectors to be a vector space, this vector addition property need to be satisfied. Now let's compare it with our regular Euclidean space AI cap plus BJ cap plus CK cap vectors, all the vectors. Okay, so the first property, does the addition of two vectors give another vector? If I add, let's say 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 5k cap into some another vector, will that give me a vector? Yes, it will give me a vector. The next question is, does the new vector belong to the same set? Will the new vector, that whatever vector I am going to get, does that belong to the Euclidean space? Obviously yes. So the Euclidean space or Euclidean vector satisfy this addition property. What about the existence of null vector? Does a null vector exist in Euclidean space? Obviously yes. 0i cap plus 0j cap plus 0k cap, this is a null vector. So it also satisfies existence of null vector. Does inverse vector exist in Euclidean space? Yes. If I am considering ai cap plus bj cap plus ck cap, then there exists minus ai cap plus minus bj cap plus minus ck cap. This is an inverse vector. So the existence of inverse vector is also satisfied by Euclidean vectors. Then is the vector addition commutative? Does the addition of vectors depend on order of appearance in Euclidean space? No. So it also satisfies this particular property. Let's look at the associative property. In addition of many vectors, does the end result depend on which vector are added first for Euclidean space? No, it is already independent. So it also satisfies associative property for vector addition. From this particular thing, we know that the vector addition properties are satisfied by Euclidean space. Now let's look at what is scalar multiplication property. So in scalar multiplication, if one multiply a vector by a scalar, then the product should be a vector and that vector should belong to the same set of vectors. What is it? So basically, mathematically, if I multiply a scalar A with a vector A, it will give me vector C, and this vector C should belong to the same set of vector that we have considered. If it does not belong to the same set of vector, then it's not a, it does not satisfy this scalar multiplication property. Then in scalar multiplication, there exists a unitary scalar such that if you multiply by that scalar to any vector, it will give you the same vector. So I into vector A will give me vector A itself. that is existence of scalar I. Then existence of zero scalar, so there should be some scalar zero, such that if you multiply zero by any vector by this zero number, zero scalar, you will get a null vector. The next property that need to satisfy is scalar multiplication is distributive. So if I multiply a vector by a scalar, let's say I am multiplying a plus b by a scalar a, then it will give me scalar a multiplied by vector a plus scalar a multiplied by vector b. Similarly, if I add two scalar number a plus b and I multiply it by a vector a, then it will give me a scalar a multiplied by vector a plus scalar b multiplied by vector a. So basically it is a distributive property. It should satisfy this distributive property as well. Scalar multiplication is also associative. What I mean by this is that the order doesn't matter, the multiplication order. So suppose if I want to multiply scalar a and b to vector a, it doesn't matter whether I am multiplying scalar b first or scalar a first, the end result will be same. So the order of multiplication by scalar doesn't matter. This is for scalar only. Okay, let's compare it with Euclidean vector spaces. So in Euclidean vector spaces, does the multiplication by a scalar gives you a vector? The answer is yes. And does the new vector belong to the same set? The answer is again yes. So this particular multiplication property is satisfied. Does there exist a unitary scalar? Yes, one. Number one. So there exists a unitary scalar. Does a zero exist? Yes, number zero. So it also satisfies this particular property. And does the distributive property followed by an Euclidean space? Yes. So it also satisfies this particular property. And does the scalar multiplication in Euclidean space is associative? Yes. So it also satisfies this particular property. So since it satisfies all the vector addition and all the scalar multiplication properties, the Euclidean vectors and real numbers, they form a real vector space or Euclidean vector space. So in summary, the vector addition property should satisfy addition of vector is a vector and they should belong to the same set of vectors. Then there should exist a null vector such that when another vector is added to a null vector, it will give the same vector back. Then there should exist an inverse of a vector such that if you add a vector to inverse of that particular vector, you will get a null vector. Then this vector addition is associative and this vector addition is commutative. So the order, the associative property and distributive property say that it doesn't matter in what order you are adding the vectors. You can add the vectors in any order. Let's summarize the scalar multiplication. So in case of scalar multiplication, when you multiply a scalar by a vector, it should give you a vector and that vector should belong to the same set. Then there should exist a unitary scalar such that when you multiply a vector by unitary vector, you will get the same vector. Then there should exist a zero scalar such that when you multiply a vector by a zero scalar, then you will get null vector. Then the scalar multiplication should be associative and the scalar multiplication should be distributive. This property needs to be satisfied. If a set of vectors and set of scalars satisfies this vector addition and scalar multiplication property, then we say that it forms a vector space or linear space. The set of vectors and set of scalars are said to be a vector space or linear space if and only if these properties are satisfied. If any of these properties are not satisfied, then the sets are not vector space. Now, usually the associative, commutative and distributive properties are satisfied. So while finding whether a set of vectors and set of scalars are vector space or not, just look for vector addition yields a vector, whether the vector addition is giving you a vector and whether that resultant vector belongs to the same set or not. Existence of null vector, whether there exists a null vector or not, whether there exists an inverse vector or not, and whether the scalar multiplication gives you a vector from the same set or not. Then the last thing that you need to check is existence of unitary and zero scalars, whether unitary and zero scalar are there in the set of scalars or not. Okay, most of the time, it's not true always, most of the time your associative, commutative, distributive properties are satisfied. So only finding this particular five things, whether vector addition gives you a vector of the from the same set, whether a null vector exists or not, whether an inverse vector exists or not, whether scalar multiplication gives you the vector from the same set or not, and whether there exists a unitary and zero scalar or not, only these five properties will tell you whether whatever the set of scalar and set of vectors are forming vector space or not. For example, I am going to consider a set of all positive vectors. So the components of the three-dimensional vectors are all positive, and I am going to consider the scalar to be a set of all the real numbers. From this particular set, I have taken one I cap only, and if I multiply it by minus 1, what will it give me? It will give me minus I cap. Does that minus I cap belong to a set of all positive vectors? No, it does not. So it does not satisfy the multiplication property. Let's talk about a problem. So now consider Euclidean vectors in three dimension with complex component. So whatever your a I cap plus b j cap plus c k cap, these a, b, c, these are complex numbers, not real numbers. Okay, and whatever the set of scalars that we are going to consider, it is also complex numbers. Okay, does a subset of all the vectors with k component 0 form a vector space? Now, if I made k component equal to 0, whether all such vectors form a vector space? For that, you need to find out whether a vector addition gives you a vector from the same set or not, whether existence of null vector, whether there exists a null vector or not, whether there exists an inverse vector or not, whether their scalar multiplication gives a vector from the same vector or not, and whether existence of unitary and zero scalar is there or not. So since thus scalar set of scalars that we are going to consider are complex numbers, so a unit scalar does exist. So basically 1 plus 0 I is your unitary scalar, and 0 scalar is 0 plus 0 I. Okay. The second question is, what about subset of all vectors with k component is equal to 1? Now, instead of making k component is equal to 0, we are going to consider a set of vectors such that their k component is equal to 1. Now, whether this will form a vector space with set of all complex numbers? And the third problem is, how about a subset of vectors whose components are all equal? So, what we are going to consider over here is all the vectors for which the components of I, components of j and components of k are all equal. As an example, 1i plus 1j plus 1k minus 3i minus 3j minus 3k. Okay, these are the vectors, and all such vectors for which the components are same, whether that particular set of vector and set of all complex numbers form a vector space or not. The answers are, for A, yes, it will form. For B, no, it will not form. And for C, yes, it will form. Hint, you need to check vector addition gives the vector in the same set or not. Does inverse vector exist? Does null vector exist? Since scalar is all complex number, unitary scalar and zero scalar does exist, as I explained previously. So, thank you for your time. Your comments and suggestions are welcome. If you like the lecture, please let me know. Please subscribe to KGS Physics Academy for new videos. Thank you.